What mass of steam at 100 degrees Celsius must be mixed with 100 grams of ice at 0 Celsius to produce water at 20 Celsius? So I have ice at 0. I have steam here at 100. I have 100 grams here. Here I have mass of steam unknown. That's my unknown. In the end, I want water at 20 degrees Celsius. Okay, so in this process, ice must melt first. Then it melts to water at 0. So ice melts to water at 0. Then this water at 0, those 100 grams, so those 100 grams ice, they become 100 grams of water at 0. Then those 100 grams, okay, they take more heat and they move to 20 degrees. So in both processes, in both steps, heat is gained. Ice first gains heat to melt, then the water gains heat to move to 20 degrees. Steam, on the other hand, first it has to condense steam at 100. First condenses to water at 100. Then its temperature goes down to water at 20 degrees Celsius. So steam first loses heat to become water at 100. Then it loses heat also to go from water at 100 to water at 20. Energy conservation tells us that heat gained must equal the heat lost. The heat gained is gained in two steps. First, ice melts. So I get mass of ice times the latent heat of fusion of water. And then, so now we end up with 100 grams of water at 0. Then the mass of the water now, it's the same as the mass of the ice. The mass of the water, now we still have 100 grams, times the specific heat of water times delta T from 0 to 20. The heat lost, first steam, its mass is M, condenses to water. So the heat lost is the mass of steam times the latent heat of vaporization of water. And then more heat is lost because now water at 100 degrees goes to 20 degrees. So you get also mass, it's the same mass of steam, same as the mass of the water, times the specific heat of water. Now it's water, and now it's going from 100 degrees to 20. So the change is 80. Notice that all quantities are kept positive because the way we write it here, heat gained equals heat lost, everything is positive. That is, I evaluate the heat gained as a positive quantity and the heat lost as a positive quantity. So we have 100 grams here, which is 0.1 kilogram. The latent heat of fusion of water is 3.3, let's say 3.35, about that, times 10 to the 5 joules per kilogram. This is 0.1 kilograms, so that will be in joules, plus the 100 grams, 0.1 kilograms. Specifically, the water is 4,186 joules per kilogram degree times 20 equals the mass of steam, which is our unknown here, times latent heat. It's the same mass of steam, so I'll take it as a common factor. Latent heat of vaporization is 22.6 times 10 to the 5 joules per kilogram, plus specific heat of water, which is 4,186 times 80. So I have the left-hand side equals M times this quantity. So the mass of steam is just the left-hand side divided by this quantity. And that gives us the mass of steam.